Hey everyone and welcome back. So today we are doing an updated fake tan routine. You loved my old one. I think I did it like a year ago. So I thought I would do a little update, show you guys what I'm doing. You guys ask me all the time. It's probably one of the most asked questions. Chrissy, do you fake tan? Do you sunbathe? Do you use sunbeds? I do not use sunbeds. I do not sunbathe either because when you're in the UK, where are you gonna sunbathe? Honey, I'll go outside and it'll be just raining everywhere. I took ages doing my hair, I'm not risking that. And another thing, I don't go on sunbeds, they're absolutely terrible for you. I'm not gonna sugarcoat it. Stop going on sunbeds, you're gonna ruin your beautiful skin. So do not do that. This video is sponsored by Loving Tan. You guys already know, you don't even need an introduction. Me and Loving Tan are like this. They are the best tan I have ever used. And trust me when I say I have used many, 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 many tans. And Loving Tan, I always go back. I buy my own stuff. They send me stuff, they gift it. But for this video, they were kind enough to sponsor it. So make sure that you check them out because they're good stuff. They're good stuff. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up and let me know what you thought about my fake tan routine. Without further ado, cue the voiceover and cue the whole routine. See you in a minute. The first thing we're gonna start off with is prep. It's absolutely key and fundamental. It helps the tan last longer and it looks more seamless and beautiful. So we're gonna shave, we're gonna scrub, we're gonna get this shit done. Oh yeah. Here we are. So I'm using my double-sided mitt from Loving Tan along with some scrub. I use this one from Soap and Glory just because the grains are a little bit thicker and they're not as fine, which I love because it means more of the skin, the dead skin cells will shed away, which is exactly what we want. And we want that fresh skin to be popping, to look lavish. So as you can see, I'm actually going in on this. I'm not even gonna be gentle because I just want all that old fake tan to wash away, scrub away. So make sure that you are really focusing on your feet, especially because it's summertime now, so we're gonna get those saucy feet out, okay? Okay, ladies? I know some people think feet are weird, but I personally don't, I think they're cool. Anyway, why do I think feet are cool? That's so weird. Anyway, so next things next, we are shaving. And as you've noticed here, I'm using hair mask, which is basically hair conditioner, to shave my legs. I do not use shaving cream. I find it really drying. So conditioner is so much more hydrating and it leaves my legs so freaking smooth, you guys. So once prep is all done, by the way, I always prep a day before I tan. The reason being, my pores will be minimized the day after when I tan and it won't seep into my pores. So I definitely always tan the next day. So after the shower, I'm gonna just lotion my whole entire soul. Like, I need it to be hydrated, glistening, glowing, and just full of flavor. I'm gonna list all the products I use down below, so don't you worry about it. So the tan I'm using is Two Tans from Loving Tan. Wow, that was a mouthful. So I use the Ultra Dark and also the 2-Hour Express. I like to combine both of the products together. You do not have to do this, but if I was to choose one or the other, definitely go for Ultra Dark if you're used to tanning. But if you are a beginner, go for the 2-Hour Express and see how that works with your skin. I use the double mitt from Loving Tan. This is probably one of the best mitts I've ever used. It doesn't leak through. I can put it in the washing machine and it's good as gold. Whenever you start tanning, make sure that you place a towel underneath just because it avoids it from going on your floors. I was gonna say on your walls, but it's definitely not gonna avoid you putting it on your walls. Just basically be careful and don't ruin your furniture. Make sure that you're rubbing the tan as much as you possibly can into your skin. Focus on the momentum when you're rubbing the tan. You wanna focus on circular motions as well as dragging the tan upward so you give it a seamless finish. And look, I literally just applied this on my leg now. Look at the difference. Can you see that? This isn't even a developed tan.
and already you can see such an instant difference. And that's what I love about this tan. You can actually see where you're applying it. It's not clear, you're not clueless. You know exactly which parts are a bit more paler than the other parts, so you know how much more tan you need. Now, my upper body is probably the most important part for me to get right, only because I expose it a little bit more than, let's say, my legs. So for me, I always focus on small amounts. I do not want you to go crazy on the tan. Focus on really small pumps to begin with. Rub it into your skin, circular motions, focus around your hands, and also you want to do your hands last. With the remainder of the tan on the mitt, make sure that you just run it over your hand. You do not want to pump fresh tan on the mitt when you are doing your hands. I promise you that. You just don't want to do that. Your hands tend to always give away whether you fake tanned or not. So that's why you do not need excess fresh tan pumped onto the mitt. Just use that excess amount that you already have left over, run it through, and you'll be fine. Now, when it comes to tanning your back, okay, this is a tricky one. I either get Jack to do it or my best pal Holly, if she's about, and she's always about. So I always get her to do my back, and it's super easy and convenient. But I know not everyone is just gonna have someone lying around to help them tan their back. And if I'm being honest, I struggle to tan my own back. So I am of no help right now. I feel absolutely useless. I'm so sorry. Do not unsubscribe. I'm sorry. Once you've completed all of your fake tan, what I want you to do is just grab a face wipe and wipe your hands, your feet, your nails of any excess tan and residue that you do not want lying around. Remember, like I said, your hands tend to give away a lot that you fake tanned, so make sure that you are cleaning these areas up and keeping everything seamless and saucy. The final thing I want you to do is grab some deodorant and spray onto areas that tend to stick the most. So for me, these are all like the cracks, like all the bendy bits. So underneath my arms, my elbows, etc. Once you've done that, you grab a long t-shirt, one that you don't really like, one that's like dirty all the time, whack that on, and then you're gonna fake tan your face. So how I fake tan my face is exactly how I fake tan my body. And also, I'm going to be completely and truly honest with you guys. I've suffered so much from acne in the past, and I've used so many fake tans that have broken me the F out badly. And Loving Tan is yet again the only tan that does not break me out. So I can sleep with this tan on and I will be fine in the morning. And now, here is the finished result. Look at me glow, look as she glows. Look at her moving her body and soul. Ooh, ooh, girl, you're glowing. That's me clicking. Okay, Chrissy, we get it. Okay, move on. I fake tan once a week. And to keep up with my tan, I use Gradual Tan. So I love to mix in Gradual Tan along with my daily moisturizer. You can do this in the morning or you can do this in the evening just before you jump into bed. And Gradual Tan is so nice because it keeps you hydrated. It doesn't mean the tan is just gonna build up and look weird and blotchy. It will look seamless throughout the week. And also another thing is, it doesn't leave any residue. It will dry so quickly and it's so easy to put on. You can put this on your face, you can put this on your body, and it will gradually build up over time. And this is a fantastic way for a beginner to try out Loving Tan. You don't always have to go for the pump mousse version.
Isn't she glowing? I mean, natural tan. It's not natural. It's definitely fake tan, but it looks hella natural. Seriously, did you see that? Did you see how my leg went from, you know, there's nothing wrong with being pale, but in my defense, I just love being glowy, tan, a goddess. Okay, so yeah, Loving Tan just did the job. I just cannot express how much I love their freaking products. So yeah, honestly, honey, it's just amazing. This tan is just Also, what I do with the gradual tan is I use it about 3 times a week. So I'll do one day on, one day off, one day on, one day off, and it lasts. And then what I like to do is once a week, just scrub my skin again, do my shaving routine, moisturize, lotion my crusty dry areas. I know we all have them. And then I apply a fresh coat of tan, and then I won't tan again. I'll just use the gradual tan, which is really nice. I've got it on right now and doesn't feel sticky. It dries instantly, so you can put white clothing on. I know it's crazy, but you can put white clothing on. Another top tip, you can buy black bed sheets if you want to. I personally can't bother to change my bed sheets to black to white, black to white. So I've always just slept in white bed sheets. I know, don't hate me, don't kill me. I'm sorry. But honestly, I just put them in the wash, put some Vanish Oxy Action in there, a bit of comfort, make your clothes smell nice, and then they're fine. That's literally all I do. But if you don't wanna risk it, if you have bougie expensive bed sheets, I certainly do not, then definitely don't risk it. Buy black bed sheets and don't fuck up your sheets. That's all I'm saying. All right, my arm is killing me. I hope you truly enjoyed this video. And yeah, that's exactly how I fake tan, and that's exactly what I do. Remember to subscribe to this channel and following your girl on Instagram. Comment down below for any future videos you'd like to see. And remember that I love you guys always and forever. You are my familia. I love you so much. I'm giving you a hug. You should be over there because you're hugging me. Okay, bye, love you.